Well, remember that the materialist level, the worldly encouragement, the materialist mind, the conventional approach, and therefore the worldly encouragement, is not to be responsible. Don't be fooled. Don't have this idealization. It's obvious that that's not what the world suggests to you and what people kind of encourage you. The world tells you to succeed, to achieve. That's got nothing to do with being fully responsible for yourself. Two entirely different dimensions. One has nothing to do with the other. Ice fishing has nothing to do with flying a plane. They don't cross anywhere. Neither does responsibility, human individual responsibility, and anything that the worldly approach would call success, achievement, results, making things happen, being great, you know. Make yourself great again. Win. The worldly admonition is not take responsibility because it's so. The worldly admonition is win. And that's insane. Because that's an abrogation of responsibility. Because if you're fully responsible for yourself, it becomes almost instantaneously clear to you that you're also fully responsible for everything. And the achievement motive and the desire to win, which is somebody else loses, kind of just exhausts itself in you. You're not interested in beating anyone, in being the first one to cross the finish line. There's no more finish line. If you're responsible, that's what it means. It means all finish lines have no application for you. That's a game somebody else is playing and wants you to play, but you're not stupid enough anymore to fall for it. Until then, you've been seduced into thinking there's something there, but there is no there there. So if you really think about it, really, really, truly think about it, you can identify how important people in your life actually have not really encouraged you to be responsible for yourself. That if you really think about what I've said to you over the years and what I've said to you personally and in groups, it's generally only the guru who demands that you be responsible. The rest of the world is trying to convince you to indulge yourself. Because generally, it means they profit if you do. But the guru is not profit-seeking. The only profit the guru is interested in is that you profit because you have God. Everything else is made up crap. It's just not real. The guru wants you to have what's real, which is God or guru. In that way, they're synonymous. The guru does want you to be a devotee because the guru knows what it means personally to be a devotee and what that will do for you, not what it'll do for the guru. Won't do anything for the guru, but it'll do everything for you. The guru, no God-commanded guru is negative toward the material level. No genuine God-commanded guru. It might be part of a teaching that's necessary for certain people at certain times, but for real, no guru is against you achieving, succeeding, even winning, but they know that there's a much better prize. Get your eyes on the right prize, is what the guru is about.